When people think about pollinators, oftentimes they think about honeybees. We keep our own cultivated honeybees in our backyard. We are keeping them for their pollination benefits, but also because we're going to harvest their honey. However, when you grow in your garden, you are growing for a wide variety of pollinators. So if you want a wide variety of pollinators, you should grow different levels of plants. That means growing things that are varying heights. Sunflowers are something that come to mind because they're really tall. And so those will bring in birds, and the bees will go up to eat those too. However, growing different shapes is important too. If you grow an umbel-shaped flower, which is like an upside-down umbrella, those are what swallowtails like to eat. Another thing that you can let go to flower is last season's carrots. It'll come up this year and then produce a large umbel-shaped flower on the top. You can let the pollinators eat that and then at the end of the season save that seed as well.
When you're planting for pollinators, you don't have to put the flowers in your garden. The pollinators will travel. So you can plant in your front yard and have your vegetable garden in the backyard, and that's okay. When you're selecting flowers for pollination, look for things that flower at different times of the year. That way you'll have a pollinator buffet that's ready to go from early spring until fall.